enter this room.
Darwin, wake up.
Hey, is Katie there?
Mess up.
The group will be fine because you both have broken the rules.
That's crap.
Did you guys get offered an exemption?
Crap.
Yes, yeah. And yes. Allie.
A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the Mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the Mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and is sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the Mole. Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the Mole.
Somebody's gonna bite the dust tonight. I don't care which one of them bites the dust yet. I know they don't care if I do. So, whoever goes down, goes down.
I don't want to go home. I feel more into this game than I have ever been. And I want to keep going.
I think right now I can't worry about the team getting money. I need to worry about lasting in this game.
It's a game, people. Hello, game. Why are you not enjoying yourself?
A new day dawns in St. Moritz. The players awaken discouraged after losing money in the last round. As they quietly eat breakfast, they miss an obvious clue right in front of them.
So, hey.
Because power is about duration, though, we have a little bit to be desired.
It takes the host to remind us that there's something in front of you folks that you're not looking at. I see this journal, no number on it. I pick it up, I open up the page, I start to read the front page there, and I get scared.
Oh, top secret, property of the Mole. If found, destroyed, do not read, that means you.
Read it.
I should read it anyway.
I don't know, it's totally a trap.
Maybe it's somebody reads it.
We're walking right into it. We walk into every single
place. All right, destroy it.
No. I want to read it.
Top secret, property of the Mole. If found, destroy. Do not read, that means you. Round one, executed player, Bob. It was almost too easy. He may have hit the bullseye, but he was way off target. If only he'd spent less time schmoozing the ladies and more time paying attention. When will they ever learn? Round two, executed player, Allie. Her drink cost them, drowning her sorrows over Bob's execution. Well, she joins her buddy now. Hope the rest get serious. Round three, to-do list. Sabotage the pot, pit one against the other, put a chill down their spines, make them beg.
Make them beg for what?
I noticed you guys are all writing in your journals like fiends. Do you guys find the journals helpful?
Yeah. Indispensable.
What kind of stuff do you guys write in the journals?
Super stuff. Note about who you think the Mole is, who you think the Mole is not, whys, wherefores.
If you could, I'd like you guys to give me a number between 1 and 11.
You never know.
4.
4.
4 is the number?
4 is the number.
We all hold up your journals in front of me? I think one of the problems in this game is that you really don't know who your friends are. So today we're going to give you some insight into at least what one other player is thinking.
Okay.
Will you all please rotate your journals 4 people to the left? These are your new journals.
Oh, come on.
You can keep them and write in them, make them your own. Whoa. And if there's anything juicy about me in them, let me know.
I actually wrote a lot in my journal. I think I'm one of the few that really expressed everything I was feeling and everything I was thinking.
Every journal I passed went from my hand to somebody else's hand. I felt sicker and sicker as I watched mine just float away. Those are my thoughts going to somebody else.
When the journals got switched, I really felt sorry for Patrick because he's just been keeping me like these copious amounts of notes and like all this information, and his face just went red.
At the moment that I switched journals and I know mine is going to Katie, that's the only thing I could focus on at the moment.
I feel like I've opened up my soul to somebody, and it's something in this game that I would never want to do.
Anderson, since he's become our own, can we do with him as we will?
Well, it depends what you mean by as you will.
Can we trade him back?
No. You're not allowed to damage the journal. You're not allowed to destroy the journal. You can write in them, make them your own. These are your new journals.
If you don't want me to read them, I won't.
Do.
Okay.
If you don't read that, you're out of your mind, Katie.
I hope there's room for me to write, though.
My God!
Holy shnikes, there's no room in here. He didn't want anybody. People were asking him, can I read your journal? And he's like, no. So I knew this was a crushing blow for him. But it would be silly for me not to look through it. It really would be.
The group has little time to absorb the loss of their personal journals because a waiter's entrance signals the start of a new game.
Yeah.
Their instructions are to choose one trustworthy player. That player must use only the enclosed photographs to find and retrieve a green envelope.
This person, wait, only one person goes.
Can help. Can help. Can help. Can help.
I would say, one person. I would say someone who knows the language a little bit. Myra.
I'll go. So if anybody else Myra wants to go.
You left for Myra. Myra. Let me see that first. Myra and Myra.
Myra. Myra.
You have 1 hour starting now.
See ya.
We left.
Yes, yes, yes,
This street?
Yes, yes, yes. Right, right, right.
Just keep going.
You'll see quickly.
Okay, thank you. Dankeschön. Dankeschön.
Neutralizer. This card grants you the ability to neutralize one of your fellow players. Once neutralized, a player cannot receive any exemptions in this round of the game. Neutralizing a player will add $10,000 to the pot.
Because Myra was chosen to retrieve the envelope, she has the ability to neutralize one other player.
Whoever she picks will not be able to receive an exemption if any exemptions are offered. Once the neutralizer has been activated, $10,000 will be added to the pot.
So it's Myra's decision how to use it?
That's correct.
Can we talk about this?
You can choose to do whatever you want with it.
Before I pull the trigger, we've had three people who've already had exemptions. Does the group feel that maybe one of those people should take it?
Definitely.
None of us want either Olavia, Dorothy, or Lisa to get an exemption. They already had one.
Yeah. Are those three people any volunteers?
Hell no.
Oh. All right. Nominations?
I nominate Dorothy.
Yeah, I nominate Lisa.
First one that seconds any one of those.
As Myra determined the three people who would be neutralized and would not be eligible for an exemption, all I was thinking was, pick Dorothy, pick Dorothy, pick Dorothy. Don't pick me.
Dorothy. Okay.
Dorothy, I choose to neutralize Dorothy.
Yes.
Because Myra has neutralized Dorothy, $10,000 is added to the pot, and Dorothy will not be eligible for any exemptions in this round.
I can't believe Darwin and Bribs nominating me for the neutralizer. So rude. I'm going to remember this.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
I heard a very interesting rumor.
What's that?
That you were totally calling someone a bitch in your diary?
That's like really strong vocabulary.
Yeah.
Players head back to their rooms with new journals to read, new questions to ask, and new suspicions to ponder.
I got Al's journal, but he didn't seem happy about that at all.
This was Katie's journal.
I had no problems with Myra getting my journal, but I asked her to cross out the nasty words I had written, and she said she had done that.
I heard a very interesting rumor.
What's that?
That you were totally calling someone a bitch in your diary?
It's a possibility.
Because that's, like, really strong vocabulary.
Yeah.
For someone you've just known, like, a week.
True.
Do you, like, hate somebody here?
Hate's too strong of a word, but it is definitely a possibility.
And I used some derogatory words just to vent because she was really making me angry. And because I couldn't voice them to anybody, I wrote them down.
I mean, you don't have to tell me, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
I was just wondering if it was true or not.
I'm not, I could tell, it could be, it could not be.
Okay.
So,
well, I'm assuming, so you're saying it could or it could not be.
Mm-hmm.
Usually means that it is, because then, I mean, if it were me, I would be like,
no.
If she doesn't like me, that's fine. It's not going to affect me, because she's not my friend, she's not my family, it's not someone that I'm going to have to spend time with. You must be so psyched that you got Patrick's journal.
Yeah, but I don't know if I'm going to read it.
It's really?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I told him I wasn't going to, so that's something I really have to think about.
I had so much information in mind. I think Dorothy has mine. You should totally read it.
Mm-hmm.
It's part of the game. You'd be silly not to, I think. Well, make use of the time.
I don't want a lot of you to know that I actually am looking through it. I talked with Heather and I told her that I would give her some information out of it. His maybe mole list is Darwin. He crossed out Olavia, which I find interesting. Dorothy and Bribs.
Actually, what's really shocking about this book is that, Rob, you didn't take any notes.
The first thought that crossed my mind when we switched journals was, good thing I didn't write too much in mine.
He has a section, which is like the mole observations. And then he has this. He just has me in there. Which I thought was really hysterical, especially because the last part, he's like, she winked at me. So all day yesterday, I was like, just winking at him.
This journal is Heather's journal.
I don't understand what she did with this book.
Well, she circles Olavia and Bob, Darwin, Olavia, Bill. And so obviously she does like all the rest of us. At any given moment, she thinks somebody else might be the mole.
Because I was so expressive and so many people weren't expressive in their journals, I think it's also a cause for suspicion. And I know that if I got something with blatant information, I would be a little bit leery of trusting that information because you are so concerned with conspiracy and manipulation and deception.
This is Bill's journal. Assuming he's not the mole, it's very poignant and honest. It's written sort of as a letter to his wife. As I read it, suddenly there will be, I feel like I'm eavesdropping.
This is my new journal, and this was Olavia's journal. Olavia had come up with what she thought would be potential mole profiles. One, if the mole was a male, and the other, if the mole is a female. I think it is quite amusing to note that I am one of her suspects because my appeal, I'm not overly attractive.
The strange thing is, I really don't think I've done anything suspicious.
No, it is your quiet and deviousness. People, I think, associate quiet with deviousness. No, but don't you think?
I guess so.
I think Lisa is a terrific ally. We seem to have similar ways of thinking and observing, but I think our personalities are different enough that we'll be able to make the most of working together.
If she's not the mole, she has a lot of traits that I do not have, and we can play well with each other. If she is the mole, I think and I trust myself to be able to recognize that and keep her sort of in a little place in the game and work on getting rid of the other people.
Lisa said that she didn't think Dorothy was the mole. And she also said that Dorothy had approached her about a coalition and she hadn't committed yet. And I told her to go right ahead because all the information I can find out about Dorothy would be helpful as well.
I really hope that Darwin doesn't know that I have a coalition with Dorothy and that Dorothy does not know that I have a coalition with Darwin, or that could be bad.
Somebody's getting wet.
Come on up here. I need you to select one player who's good at matchmaking. You have 2 minutes to decide. Start now.
All right, I want to do.
All right.
I'll volunteer.
All right.
If nobody else wants to do it,
I'll do it. Yeah.
All right, Al.
Okay,
so you've all decided?
Yeah.
All right, I'll just stay here with me. I'm actually starting to feel kind of sorry for you guys because you're not making the kind of big bucks I would like you to be making. So I've devised a game today that is simple. Simple, you guys should be able to do well, should be able to earn a lot of money. All you have to do in order to earn money is to get across this bridge. Each person who gets across the bridge, you get $5,000 added to the pot. There is, of course, a catch. Now, you all know the story of Robin Hood meeting Little John on a bridge and having to fight Little John. We have our own version of Little John, and he brought a friend, Little Jane.
Ah, here you go.
Little John, Little Jane.
Yeah. I'm looking at this beautiful mountain range, and one of them starts moving towards me. And I said, this guy is, this isn't a mountain, this is a man. And I said, oh boy, this is really going to be interesting now.
Jeez, Little John doesn't look so little.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
If you touch the water at all, game over for you. In order to add money to the pot, each player must battle either Little John or Little Jane. The group has chosen Al to decide who battles whom. If you touch the water at all, game over for you. If a player makes it across the bridge, they'll not only earn money for the pot, they'll be eligible for a second round where they'll be fighting for an exemption.
Do we have to zip these suckers up? Little John's easy.
What about Little Jane?
Oh, yeah.
Little Jane looks worse than Little John.
All right, so now fortunately for Al, he has already earned a place in the exemption round because he has crossed the bridge. So not only are you battling for money, you're also battling for the chance to face Big Al for an exemption. Lisa, you were first.
The team's matchmaker, Al, decides which opponent each player will face. The catch is at least three players must go head-to-head with the giant Little John.
Lisa will fight Little Jane.
All right, Al says Lisa will fight Little Jane.
Got this, Lisa.
Yeah!
Go strong. Go strong.
Whap, whap, Lisa bangs her, knocks her out of the way, comes right across. I'm saying, giddy up, man. Bring on the bucks, because this could be okay.
You okay, Patrick?
Yeah.
All right. All right, Heather is next. Al, who do you want Heather to face?
Little Jane.
All right, Little Jane.
Come on, Heather.
Come on, Heather.
Heather had told a couple of us she used to be a gymnast. I think that Heather, who loves the balance beam, should have been able to stand on a log that's twice the width of a balance beam, and she fell off without being touched.
Al, who do you want to build a face?
Little Jane.
Little Jane. Dorothy will be facing Little John.
Dorothy?
You can do it.
I know,
medical
friend,
Dorothy, you got it. Please, guys, you can't even hold us up.
Little John is a man approximately five times my height and weight. And looking at him is like looking at the Incredible Hulk coming at you.
I'm feeling terrible as I see Dorothy come up there. You know, she can't see anything. She's like Mr. Magoo without her glasses. She's barely on the logs. She's like making out shapes, you know, trying to swing at the mountains. Dorothy is neutralized. She's a sacrificial lamb.
So Myra is next. Who do you want Myra to face?
Little Jane.
Little Jane? Okay. Little Jane?
You're not supposed to hit in the heads, and Little Jane takes a swing and hits her right in the head, and she broke the rules, so Myra gets to cross. I'm thinking, beautiful.
All right, you have four players left. You're up $15,000 for the pot. It's now Bribbs' turn. Who do you want Bribbs to face?
Little Jane.
All right, little Jane.
Fire, Britt, you got her.
Three players left. Lavi is next. Who do you want to lobby?
I got one left. Little Jane, come on up again.
All right, little Jane.
Right.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Get her towels and towels there.
Yeah.
Only two players are left. Now Al must decide whether to pit Katie or Darwin against the undefeated little John.
Al, who do you want Darwin to go against?
Do I want Darwin to come across here and battle me for the exemption? Or do I want to have Darwin go through, you know, little Jane, have a better shot of being little Jane, more of a guarantee of putting money in the pot and sacrificing Katie?
Little Jane. All right, little Jane.
Hi, Darwin.
Well done.
Katie, you are the last player to attempt the bridge.
Poor Katie. I have no other choice but to call out the big man, Little John.
Little John. Little John?
Katie, all the blood dropped right out of dead white, and I felt horrible about it, but I had to make a decision there.
You're going down, Little John.
Come on, Katie.
Oh, it's cold! Oh my God!
All right, congratulations. $25,000 has been added to the pot. You five have made it across. You all did very well. You have made it now to the exemption round. So here's how the exemption round is going to work. Al here will decide who is going to battle whom. The last person standing will battle Al for the exemption.
Everybody seems to want this exemption when they come along. I think everybody's putting themselves before the team.
At this point in the game, an exemption is huge.
You should determine who's going to do the first battle. Oh, Darwin and Bribbs.
The two that are most like me are Darwin and Bribbs. So I think to myself, I'm going to need to get rid of one of these two first. So I'm going to put them out there and get rid of one initially. I decide to send Bill up against Darwin. If he wins again, he's gonna get even more tired. I wanna tire out the strongest person in succession. That's my strategy.
I tell you this, I hit that guy, and he didn't move one inch.
Bill and Lisa. Bill and Lisa?
Obviously, he wanted to weed out the big boys, which he did, and so then it was between Bill and Lisa. I'm sure he was thinking, you know, he could take either one of those.
I disliked going against Lisa and Meyer more than you can ever imagine. I didn't want to hit him. Sure, the devil didn't want to lose to him, but I didn't want to hit him.
I see Bill still standing at the end, and I'm thinking, oh boy, I got to go up against the big man now. He's big. He's strong. I don't care how old he is.
So what's your strategy for this?
Try to knock him in the water.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, he's a terrific guy. I hope he doesn't take it personally when I knock him in the water. This is the final battle for an exemption. Al, Bill, good luck.
If both fall into the water, then it's considered a draw, and you have to go up and do it again.
Because you were both knocked into the water, you got to start on the bridge again. Meet in the middle.
Way to go, Al.
I was just thrilled that I was able to beat him. It wasn't even about the exemption that I had won. It was just I was glad to be able to beat him.
You guys did a great job. Got $25,000 for the pot. Al won an exemption for himself.
Congratulations.
Several of us had been watching Anderson all day, and he was entirely too dry.
Anderson, I have a question.
We need to chat with you.
As far as the spa is concerned,
yeah.
Would you like to...
Oh,
We went in way out, and he came up soaking wet. He did have a dry spot on his sleeve, and I was sorry about that.
I'll remember this.
But that was for the burn bags burn.
Burn.
Yeah, there was that devious smile in the burn bags burn.
Beautiful.
I tell you, Bill, you're no joke. You just tackle people.
I do have to say that was definitely going to be a guy's exemption, though, which just kind of sucks. But
I loved the Little John game. I mean, it was a good chance to sort of get out some aggressions. Without taking out a member of the team.
Elsa. Now, Al, I am very happy. If anybody, I'm glad you got the exemption.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't feel sad at all. You earned it. It's yours.
Yeah, it's a noble
enjoy it.
I'm not really concerned about Al as a particularly strong player. I don't mind that he'll be here for another round of play. In fact, I like it.
Well, he played just a real smart game because I did a stupid thing. I wanted to go out and bully him, and he didn't let me. I played a smart game.
After a morning of fierce battle, the players get a chance to relax at a local spa. Having enjoyed some much-needed R&R, it's time to inform the players of a provision of Al's exemption.
Al, great job today of getting an exemption for yourself.
Thank you.
What Al and the rest of you did not realize is that there was also a bonus that Al got with his exemption. The bonus is a second exemption. Now, the first exemption is for yourself, and you have it. It's guaranteed to get you into the next round. The second exemption will make you the most popular player, at least till the next execution, because the second exemption you get to give away to one of the players. Ah, jeez. Al, you cannot announce who you are giving an exemption to until the dinner before the next execution, which is tomorrow night.
In the Mole's journal, it said, make them beg, and I'm sure everyone's going to do just that.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
It's a psychological game. You don't notice it until the first game hits you.
Whew, what does it hit you?
The group has learned Al has a second exemption to give away. He now has 24 hours to pick the most deserving player.
This is a curse. This is an actual curse.
Send them. Domenic, come over there.
It's a psychological game. You don't notice it until the first game hits you.
Whew, what does it hit you?
It's like a slap in the face, so it's not as easy as you thought.
So you guys plan on making a pitch?
No. How about you?
I was just goofing with him. Guy's joking around.
You're the first one there.
First person talking to Al was Patrick. And, you know, whatever, it's smart, I guess, to get in there.
I had 140 francs, but, you know, there wasn't much I could do with that as far as persuading him.
After more than a week together, the players begin to open up to each other, sharing personal secrets, their hopes and fears.
In a sense, commitment.
They know that any of this information could end up on the quiz.
But it's directly related to my past 4 months. The commitment issues have been coming up, and I guess I just realized that I do have a sense of fear of commitment. Only because I want to go off and, you know, find adventures and do whatever, and that's not committed to any one thing by any stretch of the imagination, so.
Al?
Being a nobody is my greatest fear. Just not being remembered. I don't just mean by everybody, people at large. I'm talking about my family and so forth. That's not an ego thing. I'm particularly talking about my family. It's what drives me to be, you know, the best dad, best husband I can be. You know, I want them to miss me when the time comes and I gotta go. I want to know that I made a difference and they remember that. And maybe the grandkids remember that and so forth, so.
Lisa, what's your greatest fear?
Failure. I
I like to win even little competitions. No, I mean, it's failure. I don't like to lose. And I don't know that it's sort of my greatest fear. Fear is an awkward word for that. But I don't want to be 50 years old and think, you know, and look back and say, I didn't do I don't want to have any regrets. And to me, that sort of is encompassed in the word failure.
With just a few hours left until the execution, the players use their time to relax, plot strategy, and discuss possible coalitions.
How the hell do you think this whole coalition thing is going to work out?
I don't think it's going to work this game, personally. Why are you, like, do you think you want to form some sort of...
Been approached by a few people, but I just don't understand.
Katie and I, like, the first day, decided that we were going to form a coalition. I've considered pulling Bribs into our coalition, sort of making a team out of it.
People are coming, or whatever. We'll talk later.
What's going on in here?
Hi.
Oh, no.
We're forming coalitions. Want to get out?
Oh, my.
What?
Form coalitions.
Oh, yeah.
Who's on this?
It's mine and Iris.
Can I see
you? Of course you can.
It's been an amazing ride so far.
I know. And you get to stay one more week, at least.
Yeah, I know.
That's great. I mean, I'm not trying to kiss your butt, but I'm like, I'm just happy that you got it.
Yeah.
I really am.
I appreciate that. I was so happy to get an exemption.
I really do wish you the best of luck, because I don't see myself making it to the end. I really don't, so.
I wish she's what you never know.
Trying to convince Al that I deserve the exemption is probably, like, shooting myself in the foot. I think he's already made up his mind.
Anybody want to make any bets on who they think Al is going to select? If you guys were in the position of giving away an exemption, how would you choose the person you would choose?
I'd throw it at them all.
You would give the exemption to the person you think is the mole?
Yes.
Why?
Well, then that way, if I'm correct, everybody else is still in play, and it's not really an exemption.
I think I'd give it to who I believe is the weakest player. Then, if I'm pretty sure that person's going to go no matter what, then I have a chance of getting rid of a stronger player the first time around.
It's a crapshoot. You know, I'd give it to the person, whose company I enjoy right now, only because I don't have a definite feeling on who this person is, who's the mole.
He was thinking. As you all know, with dessert comes decision time. So, Al, why don't you tell who you decided to give an exemption to and why?
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal. The player who scores the most answers incorrectly will be executed. Tonight, we do have a tie.
I put a lot of thought into this, I really did. It's a big deal, you know, getting an exemption is a really big deal. Initially, instinctively, my thought is Bill. After I found out that I was supposed to get it and give it away, in about 30 minutes of that happening, Bill came to me and said that if you're thinking about giving it to me, no prompting or prodding, he said, if you're thinking about giving it to me, I don't want it. If I'm going to get an exemption in this game, I want to earn it. And because of the respect I have for you, Bill, I will honor that request.
Thank you.
You won't be getting it.
I lost very fairly to Al yesterday in the finals. I did not earn the exemption. I sure as hell don't want to be given the exemption.
You know, I totally thought Bill was full of it when he went up to him and said, you know, don't give me the exemption because I want to earn my exemption, you know? He's setting it up to seem more honorable than he probably is, and it just smelled funny to me. It's just, I didn't believe it.
I thought about the game itself. And although some of you may disagree, I'm of the opinion that this particular game favored the men. I thought so. Because I think the men had the advantage there. No man here tonight will be gaining an exemption. So it comes down to the women. Dorothy, you're ineligible to receive one because you were neutralized yesterday. So you're out of the running. Olivia, Lisa, both of you have received an exemption already. You've earned one for yourselves, so I will not be giving you a second exemption. So that left me with three choices. Myra, you got across the bridge, and you were in the final round with the opportunity to win that exemption because you got to a place nobody else got to and had more of an opportunity than the other two. I've eliminated you. Heather and Katie, they both went down early. I chose little Jane for you. I chose Little John for you because I had no other choice. I think that, Heather, your opportunity to win was greater than Katie's opportunity, and therefore I'm granting the exemption to Katie. That's how I will.
Thank you very much.
Al was king for a day. I mean, he definitely did right for the group, and he did right for himself.
Well, I'd just like to propose to Al for a very difficult decision process, but you handled it really well.
Thank you.
Katie's probably not the mole. She's probably the weakest player here. Helps to keep her around, too. So it works out twice for me.
Take a beer now, please.
The pot now stands at $91,000. It is time once again for the quiz. 10 questions about the mole. Question number one. During the Little John, Little Jane game, whom did the mole face?
Heather, yesterday. She got knocked off the log without ever getting hit. Little Jane says boo, and Heather says, whoa, bye, and she jumped in.
Number two, does the mole have a tattoo? Number three, what is the mole's greatest fear?
What's pointing the finger to Dorothy is that she's just been really quiet. Not overly quiet, but just kind of staying in the shadows. She's very smart.
Number four, what is the mole's new journal number?
It can't be a good feeling to be executed. Tonight would be particularly bad, since yesterday was the last day that I could get my job back.
Number five, what is the mole's zodiac sign?
You know what? If Al is the mole, he deserves an Academy Award.
Number six, how many times did the mole battle during the Little John, Little Jane game?
I think Olavia could be the mole because she just has that mole-like look. Very mysterious, the arched eyebrow, very suspicious.
Number seven, what color booties was the mole wearing during the Little John, Little Jane game?
Myra could definitely be the mole. She has got me extremely worried because she's so good about not revealing too much, but revealing just enough.
Number eight, the mole went swimming at which hotel?
Right now, it's a crapshoot. Anybody who says they know who the mole is absolutely blowing smoke.
Number nine, what is the mole's marital status? Number 10, who is the mole?
I'm happy to say you've all done much better in this round. You've earned an additional $35,000 for the pot, so the pot now stands at $91,000. Al, you earned an exemption for yourself in the last game. You also earned the right to give an exemption away, and you chose Katie to receive that exemption. The rest of you are not so lucky. Now, you've all just taken the 10-question quiz about the identity of the mole. As you know, the player who scores the most answers incorrectly will be executed. And in the event of a tie, the slowest player to answer those questions is the one who must leave the game immediately. Tonight, we do have a tie. So tonight, the player who will be executed is the player who answered those questions the slowest. In a few seconds, I'll begin entering your names into the computer. If a green screen appears after your name has been entered, you remain in the game. If a red screen appears after your name has been entered, you are the game's third victim. You have to take your bag and leave the game immediately. As always, I will be entering your names in randomly. Heather. Patrick. Darwin. Dorothy. Lisa. Oh.
She was my roommate for a couple of days, and we talked about everything. And the fact that she's gone, it's gonna be hard for me.
I'm completely floored that Lisa was executed. I noticed she's very observant. She seems to have a great memory for details.
I don't think there's anybody sitting here who is as intelligent as she is. I mean, she's really, really smart.
Good luck, you guys. Good luck. And I'm gonna miss you. You're gonna have a lot of fun. Dorothy and Darwin, I hope you both kick some serious butt. I respect you a lot. You're both really, really good players.
The conversation yesterday, she said, you got to trust somebody in this game. You have to trust somebody. Yeah, how do you get along otherwise? I think that's very telling. I don't think you can trust anybody.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, you're okay.
Yeah, it was fun having
Take
you
care. Again. All right, give me a call if you're in Chicago.
All right.
All right.
We'll go to a ball game.
That sounds great. Thanks.
All right.
Bye.
Hold on.
More twists, more turns, more Mole as the Ultimate Spy Game continues. Mole 2, a brand new episode next, only on ABC.